worship you, Lord, for you are worthy of all our praise, honor, and glory. This is the day, another day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in it. Father, we thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your mercy, your love, your grace. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. We say thank you, Father. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, we just want to say how much we love you today, Father. Thank you for loving us. In spite of all our shortcomings, you still love us. Your love for us is unconditional. It never changes. And Lord, today we want to say thank you. Thank you, thank you, Father. Thank you for being so patient with us. Thank you for just blessing us with all the things that we need and even the things that we want. We just want to say thank you, Lord. And help us today, Father, that we will just say thank you. Thank you, thank you. Even though, Lord, there are times when we would make a mistake and then we would hear those voices that are telling us we're not good enough. And the enemy would try to condemn us because that's who he is. He's an accuser of the brethren. But we thank you, Father, that we can come to you at all times knowing that you will forgive us in any situation. You will strengthen us. You've already given us the strength that we can walk in you, walk in holiness, walk in righteousness, walk in your love. So we thank you, Father, for loving us unconditionally and for all the things that comes up in our lives. We thank you for taking care of them. Again, we want to thank you for your word that says the voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord break the cedars. Yes, God spoke and broke those cedars in Lebanon. And we thank you, Father, that your children, we all would remember not to listen to the tormenting voices, not to listen to the enemy, because you have already taken care of all the situations in our lives. So this day we put into your hands, we pray that your perfect will be done. Whatever we do, adults and the children, we pray that we will glorify your name in our words, our thoughts, our actions. Lord, help us to choose the things that we say and do. Create in us clean hearts, Father, and renew in us the right spirit. Help us, Father, to walk in purity in everything we do. We give you praise and we say thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. We thank God for another day. Many of us look forward to the weekend. We thank God that he has brought us all through this week. And today we would conclude our talk on purity. And I'll briefly just recap what we did. And we will do some confessions. As I said yesterday, first, we started off on Wednesday. What is the good foundation for marriage? And Lydia shared in that the good foundation is first putting God first, make sure he's the center of our lives. We honor what we do and say. And also spoke of the importance of walking in obedience. Sexual sins, that's the thing that it would not help us to walk in purity. And so we touched on fornication, that's having sexual relations without being married. We touched on adultery, which is someone having sexual relations with someone other than their spouse. And we noted all these things are sin in the sight of God. And in order for us to if we want to have a great marriage, a good marriage, we want to start in a good foundation, which is God, having God as number one in our lives. And yesterday we spoke on how can we maintain a life of purity. And first of all, we see what we need to do first. Look at the things in our lives that will come up to prevent us from walking in purity. What would tempt us, the things that tempt us from to think on lustful things, to want to be involved in sexual sins. We looked at the company that we keep, the materials that we look at, whether it's or listen to, whether it's music, pictures, books, movies, whatever. Whatever you find that is drawing you to have those thoughts or to indulge in those acts, we were told to encourage to get rid of them. Because we can be praying and asking God to help us all we can, but if we do not stop what we're doing or get rid of the things that's leading us down that path, it wouldn't help. So prayer, yes, we pray. First we get rid of those things and we pray and ask God to help us to get rid of those things. The third thing we look at was Read the Word of God. Make sure we spend some time in the Word every day, and it doesn't have to be long. And also memorize a scripture verse. Get a scripture verse that we know is going to build us up and encourage us. As I said, one of the verses that is so simple, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. That's an easy verse to memorize. And we also spoke of some other Bible verses, which we will do today. So we take a note of the things that tempt us. Videos, movies, songs, pictures, the company we hang with, the people we hang with, their conversation. What are they encouraging us to do? We put away those things that are dragging us down in that area. We pray, as I said, and we remember that God is watching 24/7. You know, sometimes I think people forget that, especially they do things in secret thinking, well, if my spouse doesn't see, it's okay, or my parents don't see. But we have to remember, the person we should aim to please at all times is God. He sees us regardless of where we go. 24/7, He is there. And so that should be our desire. We're always remembering God is there. Sixthly, we should resist the devil. We found in James 4:7 says, submit yourselves to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. And seven, take a note of the things you wear. I mentioned that, how that can affect individuals, especially the male gender, by the clothes that us females wear. Be very careful, try to cover up ourselves, not expose certain parts of our body, because it could pull someone down and put them in a state we don't want to know. We're responsible for a child turning into, getting into pornography or things that are not good. And one of the other things we mentioned yesterday, as parents, we have to be so careful, because some people may be involved in pornography. We mentioned that. And if this material get in the way of a child grab a hold of that material, it could damage that child for life. So we have to be very careful. A lot of times people say, oh, it's my life, I'm going to do it my way. But whatever we do, it always affects someone. And one of the things I forgot to mention yesterday, the Lord reminded me last night, as adults or parents, because of our role in the family, whatever we do affects our children. And so if there's a mother or a father that's involved in something like pornography, or is involved in having relations out of their marriage, they're married and they're not being faithful, that's an opening the Lord. So you're opening a door, a promiscuous spirit. You're opening that door for a promiscuous spirit to visit your family. And then you want to know, if your daughter or son begin to do certain sex acts at a very young age, you wonder why. But because you, as the adult, has brought about that opening. So it's a very serious thing, especially when you're a parent. Yes, things may not be going the way you want it to go, but especially if you're a child of God, that's when we come to God. We come to the Word of God. We look for Bible verses for that situation. We read them, we confess them, and we pray. So again, it's very important. And as I'm speaking this now, I remember years ago, as I was reading that story about, what's the man's name? When the people of Israel, they went out to fight the war, and the Lord told them to get rid of all the spoil, Achan. And Achan brought home some of the spoil and he hid it. And after he did that, the army of Israel, when they went to fight again, they lost the battle and they lost many soldiers, many of the men. And the man of God said, there is sin in the camp. Somebody's sin that caused this to happen. And when they checked it out, it was Achan. And because of Achan's sin, this thing always troubled me, and I'm like, wow, this just to show the importance of us as parents. Because of Achan's sin, so many people lost their lives, and because he was the head of a household, he was punished, he was stoned to death, his wife was stoned to death, all his children were stoned to death. The entire family was punished because of the father's act. It's very important. What we do as head of households, it affects our children. And either we create an opening for the presence of God, or we create an opening for the enemy. So again, if you are into pornography, man of God, woman of God, or if you are in a relationship, you're married and you're in a relationship that is outside of your marriage, a sexual relation, God is saying we need to stop. We prayed that prayer yesterday, but the Lord just reminded me to mention this to you, the significance of us as parents, our role that we play. Whatever we do, the role that we play, whatever we do affects our children, either positively or negatively. And you may be doing it in secret and they may not be seeing it, but it just opens the door. We open the door to the presence of God, to the Spirit of God, or we open that door to the demonic presence. So let's be careful. All right. So today, I would like to go through some of the verses that we did yesterday. And again, for those who may have been in a situation where they've been hooked on this for years, and it may be hard for you to break loose from it or to stop, God is faithful. You can do all things through Christ. And the Word of God says there is no temptation given to man that God would not bring you out of that temptation. He's going to always find a way of escape. And so even as I'm bringing the word today, this is an encouragement to you. And we're going to be confessing some scriptures that would help us. So what we need to do in order to stay away from that, get rid of the things that is enticing us, get rid of the friendships if you have. And when you need advice on dating and courting and relationships, do not go to somebody in the world. Go to somebody who is of like kind, a man and woman of God. Ask the Lord to direct you to that person, because the people in the world, they don't know God, and they would not be able to give you advice based on the Word of God. Now, 1 Thessalonians, we did it yesterday, I'm going to do it again today. 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 3 and 5 says, God's will is for you to be holy. So stay away from sexual sin. Then each of you will control his own body and live in holiness and honor, not in lustful passion like the pagans who do not know God and his ways. So you go to an ungodly, maybe it's a close friend or a family, a relative, asking them for advice. If they don't know God, they would not be able to advise you in the wise things of God. So our aim, our desire is to should be to be in the Word of God, spend time in it every day. And I'm going to repeat this again. It may sound repetitious, but it's just to remind us why we need a word. It's like in the natural. We need food in order to survive. Food to give us that energy to fight against sicknesses and viruses, to build our bodies up. Likewise, we need the Word of God, the Bible, which is going to give us that some spiritual food. And if we do not feed on the Word of God, we are going to slip, we're going to fall, we're going to get into sin, because we become weak. Okay, so we need to feed on the Word of God. You may say, I'm busy, but always ask yourself, what is important in my life? What is important? Being a child of God and walking in obedience, living to please God, if that's important to us, we will make the time, because as I said, we cannot survive without the Word of God. Reading the Word of God, praying, spending time in His presence, listening to Him, and walking in obedience. And even if you may slip a day, you wake up late and you can have your devotions in the morning, you can have your Bible reading. We all have these phones. We just Google. We could Google the same, any scripture verse on the phone. As I said yesterday, you could just Google Bible verses on purity, and those verses would come up, and you could just memorize one of these verses. So one of the verses that we'll start on today, I'll say it, and then I'll use the first person, put in the word I and me, and so you can repeat, please, if you would like to, but it would be great if you could. So 1 Thessalonians 4, 3 to 5 says, and you could repeat, God's will is for me to be holy, so I will stay away from sexual sin. With God's help, I will control my body through the reading of His word, through praying, so that I will live in holiness and honor, not in lustful passion like the ungodly or the unsaved who does not know God and His ways. That should be our prayer. The other confession that we would confess today is found in Matthew 5:8. It says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. And that's the easy confession. We could make this confession. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. That's Matthew 5:8. And Philippians 4:9 says, which is one of my favorite verses, it says, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think on these things. So our confession would be, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if there is excellence or anything that's praiseworthy, I will think on those things. The next confession is found in 1 Timothy 4:12. I'll read a verse, then we make the confession. Do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Our confession. I will be an example for the believers in conduct, in love, in faith, and purity. And we can be that example by always staying in the Word, making the Word of God our guide. Always remember, whatever we do affect others. It's not your life. Yes, it's your life. And a lot of people like to say, it's my life, let me live my life. But it affects others. Remember, there are younger children that are looking on to you, looking up to you. As I mentioned to you yesterday, of that 9-year-old, you know, he was so fascinated by this adult, the way she dressed. And the enemy was starting to work in that guy's mind. Thank God he spoke with his mother and she was able to tell him it was the wrong thing to do and not to be feasting on that. And so here again, the way we dress, women of God, let's be careful. It could cause a child or an adult to stumble, all right? So again, I will be an example for the believers in my speech, in my conduct, in love, in faith, in purity. Thank you, Jesus. The other confession is, excuse me, Luke 11:34-35. Your eye is the lamp of your body. When your eyes are healthy, your whole body also is full of light. But when you are unhealthy, your body also is full of darkness. So see to it that the light within you is not darkness. What this verse is saying, your eye, people would call it your eye gates, is the lamp to your body. When your eyes are healthy, so whatever comes, whatever we choose to look at, we have to make sure that it would bring light. There it comes to the movies, the books, and the videos, all those things. So we do not want to be bringing darkness into our lives. So our confession would be, in the name of Jesus, and with the power of God, I would allow my eyes to only see things that would bring glory to God. The books I read, the pictures I look at, the movies I look at would all bring glory to God. Because I want the light of God to be rich in my life. So whatever we allow our eyes to see, again, I'm going to read the verse. Luke 11:34-35. Your eye is the lamp to your body, of your body. When your eyes are healthy, your whole body is also full of light. So if we look at things that are pleasing to God, then our eyes will be healthy. If we look at the things that are not pleasing to God, remember yesterday I said pornography, when I looked in the dictionary, I didn't read the meaning because of some words there I don't want to be in the ears of the children. But the synonyms, two of the synonyms were dirty books, filthy. And I said, my goodness. So looking at that, it says it's filth, it's filthy. We do not want that to be, we do not want to be entering that into our system, into our bodies. We do not want our eyes to be looking at filth. That's just an example. So see to it that the light within you is not darkness. See that the light within you is not darkness. Hallelujah. Okay, I got a few minutes and then we move on. How can a young person stay on the path of purity by living according to God's word. That's Psalm 119:9. So a confession would be, I will stay on the path of purity by living according to God's word. Again, I will stay on the path of purity by living according to God's word. And God's word said, as yesterday I said, some people may say, give me a scripture. Show me where the Bible says that it's a sin to have sex before marriage. And it says here, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 2. But because of the temptation to sexual immorality, each man should have his own wife and each woman her husband. And any sexual activity outside of marriage, Paul called sexual immorality. The church at Corinth, they had lots of questions they asked Paul. And Paul said, he encouraged them, he said, do not cohabit. Let me read it to get the full gist of it. It's 1 Corinthians 7. And I'm going to read from verse 1. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Corinthians 7, verse 1. Now, as to the matters of which you wrote me, it is well, and by that I mean advantageous, expedient, profitable, and wholesome for a man not to touch a woman, or to meaning to cohabit with her, but to remain unmarried. But because of the temptation to impurity and to avoid immorality, let each man have his own wife and let each woman have their own husband. Here it specifically shows that it's an act that God dislikes, to be cohabiting together, living home together. And that's the thing we touch. Some people say, well, I have to try it, what I'm getting into, so let's do this, let's live home, let's try it out. Again, if you're a woman of God or a man of God and your friend is encouraging you to do that, you should say no. It's against the words of God, it's against God's standard, and so I will not. Hebrews 13:4 says, let marriage be held in honor among all, and let the marriage bed be undefiled, for God will judge the sexually immoral and adulterous. So here is another scripture that tells us God will judge. So our confession would be, I would hold in honor marriage. I will not let the bed be undefiled, for God will judge me for every sexual immoral act. That's straightforward. God will judge us. It's a sin. And so today, as I said yesterday, the word is coming to us all in love. And why are we talking in this? The Lord asked me to share. And many times there are many individuals that are waiting on God for a spouse. And one of the things the Lord said to me yesterday, waiting on God for a spouse, and they do not want to fornicate. And so they get involved in things like pornography and all kinds of stuff. And the Lord said, he said, you know what? I'm a person, the Lord, I only give good gifts. And if you're waiting on me for your spouse, for that woman or that man, I cannot give you to that individual, because right now what you are practicing, you would not be a good gift to that individual. So if I'm going to only give good gifts, the only way I'm going to bring you together with the person that I have for you is when you have made a choice to put that away, come to me, ask me to help you to get rid of that addiction or to get rid of that stronghold, and you turn your life around, that's when. So do not believe the lie of the enemy. I have urges, I have to go ahead and do this. God is saying, no, wait on me, get into my word. Yes, you may have desires, but get into my word. This is your strength. This is what's going to help you. Okay, our time is almost over. So we're going to stop here for today. But I'm going to read this verse again. And the confession. Let's go. Yeah, the confession for the children today is, excuse me. Blessed are the peace, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. That's Matthew chapter 5, verse 7. Simply mean to, to be merciful. God is good. Excuse me. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My voice. voice as well in Jesus' name. Simply means to be kind. Be kind to everyone you meet, regardless. And as you show kindness, kindness will be granted unto you. And for us today, our verse is, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. So we want God to help us to create a clean heart. And how would he do that? By the word. So we spend time in the word. We stay away from those things that are pulling us in that area. Let's all remember as adults, whatever we do, especially if we have children, we're bringing either blessings or cursing our children. Whatever we do, we're opening the door for the blessings of God, or we're opening the door for the enemy to come and make a mess with our children. Again, remember Achan, he sinned. When he sinned, his entire family was punished, not only him, his household. Likewise, if a father or mother gets involved in sexual immorality, promiscuous lifestyle, that spirit would come after the children. It's an opening for that to affect your children. So let's pray today. Ask God for the strength. He is going to give us that strength to walk in holiness, to walk in purity. Let's remember the word that says, be ye holy, for I am holy. And we can do all things through Christ. Why? Because we have the word of God in our lives. So we will go today as usual with our song, Miracle Working God. And yes, if someone may have been involving these type of activities for years, yes, it may be hard for you to stop. It probably has become an addiction, but God works with the impossible, and he will help you as long as you're willing to do what he says. You're willing to spend time in his word. You're willing to turn away. You're willing to throw away those things that is luring you into that area. God will help you, and you will receive your deliverance. So I pray that you receive this today in love, knowing God cares for you. He wants the best for you. He desires your holiness. Hallelujah.
Let us exalt his name together.
Thank you, Jesus.
I sought the Lord and he heard me.
Hallelujah.
And delivered me from all my fears.
Yes, Lord.
God has delivered you today.
Thank you, Jesus.
As we worship the Lord.
Oh, we worship you, Lord. Yes. Miracle-working God. Miracle-working God. Miracle-working God. Nothing is too difficult. He's the miracle-working God. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Hallelujah. We have a God who specializes in every area of our lives. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord. He will provide everything that you need. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. He guides you in the paths of righteousness. His word will help you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. In my miracle, thank you, Lord, I receive my miracle from the supernatural, supernatural working God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He's a miracle-working God, miracle-working God. Nothing is too difficult. Oh, the Lord says, I love you with an everlasting love. I want the best for you and your family. And I'm here for you at any time. I'm here for you because I want the best for you. Hallelujah. And the enemy may try to tell you, you cannot quit. This is who you are. You've been doing this for years. Ignore that voice. God can deliver and restore you. God specializes in that. So bring it all to God. Hallelujah. I walk. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we bless your name, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. From my supernatural working God. Hallelujah. Let's sing together. Miracle working God. Miracle working God. Nothing is impossible. He's the miracle working God. Miracle working God. Yes, he is. Nothing is impossible. He's the miracle working God. Hallelujah. We bless your name. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to your name. My God specializes in the impossible. bring your pain, yes. Oh, we thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to your name. Nothing is too difficult. He's the miracle working God. Hallelujah. Yes. Oh, we bless your name. Yes, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Nothing is difficult for a God. Oh, we bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, he's a miracle working God. Thank you, Lord. And Father, today I thank you for each of your children. We thank you for strengthening us, Father. We thank you that we're drawing on your strength, and we can and will do all things through you who strengthens us. So, Father, every tormenting voice, every, every stronghold, every addiction is broken because of your word. And so I thank you, Father, that the stronghold in the lives of your children are broken. They would not walk in fear. They would not allow the enemy to torment them. They would not allow the enemy to bring to deceive them, letting them think they could get away with it. It's okay, you need to satisfy. But they will come to you knowing that you are there with them and you will help them through this situation. So we thank you for your strength. Thank you for your power to live victorious lives, to live lives of purity, Father. Thank you that we will be an example to our children. We would be an example to the younger generation, Father. We would all live lives of purity unto you. We give you praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you all for joining us. And again, as you go out today, remember, look for someone, give them a compliment. That compliment, you don't know it means, encourage them in a very special way. And let's remember, next Tuesday is Testimony Tuesday. And bring your testimonies. If you could send them in prior to Tuesday, that would be great. And listen, we've had the time of where we did the confessions, the medical confessions on health and healing. We did the confessions on finances. And if you, in any way, doesn't have to be a big testimony, if God has ministered to you, whether it's through the word, whether the word has encouraged you, whatever you see, whatever, and maybe you prayed and fasted, and then we had that time of rejoicing, praise for the 7 days. If there's any testimonies, I'm sure there are testimonies, and I know some people don't like sharing, but here, you share it. You don't have to put your name, or even if it's hard for you to write something, you don't have the time, you could videotape yourself just testifying and send the video in, because sometimes it's easier doing the video than writing. So in whatever form you want to do, send it in, godslovenest@gmail.com, or you could put it on my page. And we just want to glorify God. When we testify, we give praise to God, and we encourage others, and we let the enemy know that we know whose child we are. We are not alone. We are victorious in God. So get those testimonies in next week, Tuesday. Testimony Tuesday. Let's testify of the goodness of God. Thank you all for joining us. Have a great weekend. Let's walk in God's goodness, his faithfulness. Remember, you're not alone. Greater is God who is in you than he is in the world. And you can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. So today we all should aim to walk in holiness, walk in purity as unto God. Because we all want to be great examples to the unbelievers, an example to the younger generation. And young man and young lady, you can do it. Do not let your friends control your life, but let the word of God be your guide. Thank you all for joining us. Be blessed. Have a great day. Walk in his blessings. Walk in God's power. Walk in his anointing and his authority. See you on Monday at 6:30 a.m. Have a blessed day.